Let us now discuss the construction of an ammeter by using a galvanometer. If we are given a galvanometer with the parameters Ig and Rg, that means the full deflection current of the given galvanometer is Ig and its coil resistance is Rg. And if we plan to construct an ammeter of range IA, where the value of IA is quite large compared to IG, because galvanometers are generally used to measure very low current of the order of milliampere range. Even some galvanometers are so sensitive that these are used to measure microampere currents also. Whereas ammeters are generally used from milliampere to hundreds of ampere range we use. So, if we wish to construct an ammeter which can measure currents up to the range IA, and for this we are using a galvanometer of full deflection current IG and coil resistance RG. And this would be the situation where we have a galvanometer. We can consider its coil resistance is Rg and it deflects full scale when a current Ig is passed through it, which we have discussed in the previous section. And we wish to transform it into an ammeter such that when a current Ia is supplied to it, it will deflect by full scale. If the same current is directly supplied to galvanometer, it will get damaged because it is excessively high compared to the full deflection range. So, in this situation, we need to connect a very low resistance in parallel combination to this galvanometer, which we call RS, or this is called shunt resistance. And the shunt resistance is used to bypass the excess current through the galvanometer. And the value of shunt resistance is chosen in such a way that when a current IA is supplied to the deflection type meter, most of the current passes through shunt resistance and only IG passes through galvanometer, which will deflect it by full scale. So, if we change the scale readings of this galvanometer from 0 to IA rather than 0 to IG, in that situation when IA current is supplied, IG current will pass through galvanometer and remaining current, that is IA minus IG, will bypass through the shunt resistance and it will reach the other terminal, and finally the current which will come out from the meter will be IA only. And the shunt resistance is kept in a box which is hidden. Only thing which is visible from outside is the scale of this meter. And if we change the scale from 0 to IA, from outside world it will appear that when a current IA is supplied, it is deflecting by full scale. So now it can be treated like an ammeter of range IA. So this system, or this box in which the whole circuitry is kept, can be termed as an ammeter of range IA. Now in this situation, we need to calculate the appropriate value of shunt resistance which will exactly bypass current IA minus IG through it. So in this situation, we can say that the coil RG and the shunt resistance, these are connected in parallel. Then in this situation, always the potential difference across these two will remain same. So we can write IG RG must always be equals to IA minus IG multiplied by RS, and if we simplify this, we get the value of shunt resistance is equals to IGRG divided by IA minus IG. And as IG is very small compared to IA, this RS can be approximately written as IGRG upon IA. Here we can neglect the value of IG in comparison to this IA. So this is the value of shunt resistance we require. Like for example, if the value of full deflection current of galvanometer is 10 milliampere and its coil resistance is say 50 ohms, and we wish to transform it into an ammeter of range I is equals to 5 ampere, then in this situation the required shunt resistance can be written as Rs is equals to, in the situation it is Ig, which is 0.01 ampere multiplied by the value of Rg is 50 ohms divided by, we can put the value of ammeter current is 5 ampere. So, on calculation we are getting it 0.1 ohm. So, this is the shunt resistance required, which when connected to the galvanometer, of which these are the parameters, it will be transformed into an ammeter of range 5 ampere. This is the way how galvanometer can be transformed or converted into an ammeter of desired range.